Welcome to my channel, Fat Dandy Lines. My name is Mildred Lee, and now we're gonna start.
I'm sorry.
I'm put you in the stand, and let's see if I have a little bit of space. It's quite crowded. Sorry, this is a coffee jar. I didn't take the etiquette out or the label out because otherwise I cannot stick something on it, and I've not decorated yet, so I thought just put all the washi tips, the glittery ones, in here. So there it is. That's the ringing of the glass. So let's start. I know the table is very messy. I am sorry about that. It's not what I planned for, so I'm gonna look for something that I can clear the table, because it's too much, and I'm not sure how to do everything now. I haven't planned, so I am just on the go doing it. So this pillow box, I'm gonna fold it in half, and I've decided to do this as the front. Don't know what to do with the flap, if I'm gonna leave it like that, don't know. So let's see, how can we do best thing, because I have a lot of things on the table here. These breads, I'm so happy I didn't electrocute it myself, or short cut, or how do you call it, a short bloat fuse. This fell accidentally on my how do you say it, in my fuse, no, not fuse, in my, I don't know how to call this thing, it's an electrical appliance where you socket, yes, pop socket, socket. This I don't know why this box was open. All the contents fell in the socket. I'm so glad that nothing in the house was yesterday blue fuse. So I'm so mad at myself that I made such a grave mistake. But luckily, this kind of metal did not induce. I almost burned out my house down. So I'm sorry about this little too much information. Let's think. I wanted these, the part of the coloring page I wanted to add in it, but don't know how to do that. Let's see. I need to find a space. I hope I'm not filming it off frame. What I'm trying to do, this little coloring page, and I need to do a fold. So I'm having a metal ruler, and I'm looking for my bone folder. Yes, there it is. And I need to cut a line like so, so I can fold it easily like that, and that's gonna be like this. So that's great. I have a small card with an envelope, and I think I'm gonna use that too. So I'm gonna place the card, an actual card, in here. Put the envelope like this, so I can punch a hole also in the envelope. So then you get this little label spot. And I wondered if I could, I've cut this paper. Let's see if I can find the paper. Where's the paper? This paper, you can only find in the photo album, I think, in the past. I think you can still find in the actual photo albums. I mean blank, new from the store. The white pages are for to stick the photos on, but between the white pages you have this beautiful shimmery see-through, it's not vellum. I don't know what they name this paper, you know. Every paper, kind of paper you have in the world, they have a certain name of that. This kind of shimmery paper is between the, is a layer between two pages for to sticking your photos, your pictures, onto the white blank sheet pages. So this was actually A4 size. I already cut it with my paper cutting machine to its shape, but I think it's still, yes, it's too long. But I do not mind that it's a bit too long, because I can fold it like this to create some kind of belly band or pocket. So that's what I plan to do. So let's show you again. I have all these papers, but I want to also add a craft paper in it. Yeah, I know it's going to be quite thick. Want to fit in a craft paper somewhere. Let's see how I'm gonna do that. Can I fold it the other way around? I need to fold. Let's see if I can fold it in half. Like so. And add this paper also in there. So I need to create, I'm going to do the other side, it's better. So this is not the shimmery side, that's the shimmery side on this side. I want to make a belly band right now, but I have to ensure to see how big that paper is going to be. So I'm going to take the sample of the craft paper, so I know exactly how much I can fold. Sorry. You don't have to do it back to back, the paper at the same length. You can do also one size smaller. But I think I'm gonna keep it this way. No, I need, it's still too long, wait. Let's see if I did it. I need to do it exactly perfect. And perfect, do making a little bit perfect. It's not my forte. Let's see. Is it the correct size? Oh, yes. I think a little bit shorter. Like so. And I need to fold that. Of course, I could use a ruler and do it more exactly. And this, I'm going to fold it to make some kind of pocket or a belly band. And do it that way. So now I have the fold line in here. I'm going to grab everything. And I have to put the craft paper also. I think the craft paper goes in here. And the envelope, I'm going to put it in the middle. Do you think I have enough paper? Because it's quite thick now. And I haven't put the goodies in yet. So I'm going to show you. This is the front of the pillow box. The greeting card, I'm going to put it next. The page of the coloring page. And I've folded not like this. I turn it the other way around, like that. The layering of the photo album paper. I call it that because it has that kind of print. It's not the exact exact original layer of the photo album. I mean, it looks exactly like that. I've already pre-folded everything, put a bit of craft paper in between, and the envelope of the greeting card. So now I'm going to check everything all over again. If it needs to be, I have to say it correctly. I can use this one, or let's see if I can. Or this one to punch now the hole, because if I thread everything, it's sometimes difficult to punch a hole in here. So I'm gonna do it now, because I've learned from the past everything I've done, and I'm doing afterwards the punching, the hole on the side here. It's quite difficult to do it, so that's why I'd rather do it now, so I can see for myself. This is not gonna, so no, I don't need to make the punching, because now I have to think, oh, I forgot something. Two other more printed paper, and I thought to myself, maybe I can put on the blank space, so I don't need to put it in it to thread it, because it's quite too much in my opinion, because like I said, I didn't put the goodies in yet, so it's going to be more thicker than it is. So I think I'm going to use this pattern paper as to cover the blank spots. I'm going to do that, and there's one page, that's this one, the coloring page. I want to fold it the same way. I could find a paper cutting machine, and without the paper cutting machine, there is this little knife, a little knife like this. You can, instead of cutting the actual paper, you can make a dent with that. But I don't, last time I did it, I didn't say anything. I was filming, and instead of making a line fold, I've actually cut the paper. And when I saw I've cut the paper, I said to myself, oh no, I did it wrong. So luckily I could put some tape or washi tape to cover that cut with the knife. So I don't want to do it that. I don't want to use the paper cutting machine. That's what I'm trying to tell you. I want to do it with a ruler and a bone folder, and that's more safe. Then, so now I'm going to show you. So I know exactly where the line is. Here is the line. So on that line, so I can take carefully the spot, the paper out, because I need the cutting board to see where the line is. Oh, sorry, it's out of frame. Push you forward so I can push the makeshift camera back, so you can see now the cutting board. So like this, find the ruler and put it like this. Let's see, and then cut with the bone folder. I'm sliding a little bit upwards, so it's for me easy to fold like this. Can you see the fold? So now I can fold the paper forwards. Let's see. And then with the bone folder here, I can flatten it more straighter and more compact without ripping the paper. So now I want to show you. I'm going to turn the page. You see, this is the coloring page. I've folded once, and with the flap, the excess paper, I made a flap like that. So now I have to see. So I have to do it like that, and then put everything back where, oh gosh, my belly says, oh, that means I'm hungry. I haven't eaten lunch. That was my lunch. Oh gosh. So I have note paper page, and I thought to myself, I want to add that paper too, but I don't have, do I have space for that? No, I'm gonna put it separately. I'm gonna put it separately. So I'm gonna still scrunch everything together. You can do it as perfect as you want, but I'm not gonna do perfect as I want, because I already know, sometimes eyeball it, and I'm still not doing a perfect job, but I'm trying to. It's not that I'm not putting effort. So now I have to think about how many holes I need to punch, because now some papers are shorter than the other. So I'm gonna punch it kind of in the center. Of course I use a sponge, otherwise I would punch a hole in my table, and I don't want to do that. It must go through all the papers. And I have to think about the threading. In my mind, I'm now thinking, if you're thinking about what is she doing? I'm now thinking in my mind how to thread it. Okay. So I know how much holes I need to punch. Of course, don't punch in your fingers. Punch in the sponge, like so, you see? If you're not confident, then put two sponge on top of each other. Or you can bind it or sew it on two spots with a needle and a thread, so it won't, or on four spots, but I'm, so you can punch holes in the center. So I'm gonna, let's see how much, how far. Okay. So let's see. Can you see it? Oh, sorry, it was out of frame. You can see there's light. That's the, I've punched through all of the papers. I have chosen, the last time I've chosen, I still haven't cleaned it up. I've chosen this dark gray thread. So now I want more ochre color, even though it's not the same color as the all the papers. But I'm gonna show you. I need to unroll it first, because I need to show you why I chose the ochre color. On one of these printed paper has some kind of yellowish, orangey ochre color. And I'm gonna take you off the stand, and there is one, there is the wings there, the light blue and yellow orangey color, ochre color. That's why I chose this color for the thread. So now I'm gonna put, maybe I should have punched the holes not from the inside to the outside, because I see the holes are, the papers coming out. Maybe that was not a good idea doing that, but hey, you learn on the go. Where's my, yes, here. I call it needle, but I don't know how to call it. There, when I bought it on AliExpress, it didn't actually say what the name was, how this is called. So I'm gonna carefully see, no, it didn't go all the way through the thread, so I have to do it. See, I can see it almost coming through. No, I need to punch